Hey everyone, so first of all, it's Christmas Eve today, and I just want to wish you a very Merry Christmas if you celebrate it, Happy Hanukkah, whatever you celebrate. Thank you so much for all of the support in 2020 and the years before that. I hope 2021 is a better year for everyone. It sucked, it truly sucked, and we did learn a lot from ourselves this year, so we have to take that in as well. We might have learned a lot about our own personality and educated ourselves on other people, so that's a good thing. Now let's get into the video today. The video today is things you might forget to stock up. And yes, I am making this video because with the Halloween update, I forgot to stock a few things and that made me so angry that I have to wait another year. So in today's video, I am going to put some things out that you might want to keep after Christmas and that you might forget about. So let's start with the first one. The first one, very important, when you click on yourself, you can make a snowman. And so as you roll the first ball, you wait until it says place. There we go, and then you place it, and as you can see, you got a tiny ball on the ground right now, and you might think, that's a bit strange. You don't make the snowman with it, you just place the ball like that, and I did it over here in the corner already, where if you keep some of the balls, they're actually turning into kind of like tiny bushes, but they're not quite tiny bushes, so you can combine them into your gardening. As you can see, now you have three different types of bushes that you can have, so I suggest you roll up a few balls. Oh my god, that sounds so wrong. But you roll up a few of them, and then you got three different types of bushes that you can use throughout the year. I want like 100 of them, maybe 200, because I do think they look very nice. So I'm gonna spend an afternoon rolling some snowman without actually stacking them, because I do think it looks so pretty. Then next up has to do with the garlands. So this item is only for sale during Christmas. Now you have to keep in mind, the normal one, the standard placement one, if you place that, it will go into your inventory after Christmas is over. If you have placed garlands with the tiny ball that you can just drag onto the ground, then it will not save into your inventory. So keep in mind to stock some normal ones like that without custom placement, just so that you can keep some for the next year or just not when Christmas is around. But I feel like this is like the most important one to keep in mind. Then of course, if you want the Snowtech Mobile, stack some of those. But keep in mind, if the snow is gone, your snowmobile will be super slow. I'm actually gonna show that right now. This is gonna cost me more money than I was hoping for. I've actually been working weekends so that I go back to 1 million every week, but it's hard. See, as you can see, it is super slow when it's not on snow. That rhymes. I'm a poet again. But when you're on snow, it's super fast. It also does the same thing. What? Oh, I forgot I had a vehicle somewhere. But if you paint the floor on your plot white, like this one, it will actually work and make it go as fast, but it's useless since if the snow is removed, your vehicle will be super slow. And I feel like there's a lot better options than to have a very slow $70,000 vehicle around. So you might not want to stock that one. The next has to do with the snowball pyramid and then the bucket of snowballs. So if you have those, I would stock them up quite a lot. Well, not quite a lot. I did stock quite a lot of those, not gonna lie. If you paint them in green or red, depending on what you prefer, just gonna add another bucket inside that one. And then one is going to be painted in a green color. Okay, that doesn't truly work. What if I rotate them? Like that, okay, yes. That looks a lot better. As you can see, you got like red and green in here. If you place that next to an apple tree, going into gardening, and you place that right next to the apple tree, it looks like you just harvested some apples from the tree. It's a nice detail to add to your game and just something fun to do. So you can make an orchard like that, or orchard. Oh my goodness. Then of course, as you can see on my plot, I already did that, but we have the normal pine tree, but if you want to add some volume on your plot throughout the year, you go into the new category, and then you go into the large Christmas tree, and as you can see, this is a larger version of the normal pine tree that we have, so I stocked quite a lot of those as well. And then you also have the giant Christmas tree, and if you place that next to it, you have a very, very large bear tree, so don't decorate them. Just keep them as is. And as you can see, you can create a lot of volume on your plot placing those trees around when it's not winter and you just want like some nice foresty area with more volume. This is the way to go. Stock a lot of those trees. You might not have thought of this, but this is actually quite useful throughout the year. The only negative about that one is that the foot of the tree has like this thing around it. So you can basically cover that up if you want to, but it's not standing out too much and it's just nice to have some volume on your plot. not. Now, another tip I wanted to give you. As you can see, some items have, this item is only for sale during Christmas. The ropes don't have it, so that means that they will stay. Same with some other things. So this item is only available during Christmas. And there you can see what kind of stuff will disappear. Now, this holiday outdoor lamp, you might think, that's quite weird. I'm not gonna stock that up. But in all honesty, if you paint it black, it looks so much, not the lamp, it looks so much better than the actual normal lamp that we have in game. It looks like a Victorian type of lamp. So yes, I did stock quite a lot of those as well. If you go into lighting and then you place the normal street light, where is it? The classic outdoor lamp. As you can see, this new one looks so much better in my opinion, and there's so much more that you can do with it. So yes, definitely stack some of those up. You might think it's a little weird to stack some red and white lamps, but if you paint them black, they actually turn into quite normal lamps. Then stock some sleds as well, because if the sleds disappear, you'll no longer be able to use them. They will also disappear off of the mountain. So if you want to make some sledding stuff, definitely stock some of those up. The inner tube, for example, you could just stock that and put it into your inventory. Have fun with it, but I would definitely recommend stocking some of them. Then the reindeer. Reindeer, very important. If you want to create a farm or something like that, have a lot of reindeer. I probably have a lot in my inventory already. Yes, I have 86 reindeer in my inventory. I would definitely stock some of those. If you like to create some farms or foresty areas, you can put reindeer in the middle of them so that it looks like there's some wildlife inside it, which is amazing. Now, we don't have the fireworks just yet, but if they come out, stock them up as well. And then, of course, but this is a personal thing, the nutcrackers. I love to stock some of those just to troll my friends when they give me co-owner. I love to put them right behind a door or something like that. So like this, wait, let me put my placement grid a bit on small, or just in the shower. So when your friends want to shower, they see that. But yes, I showed that in the update video as well. I think it's so funny to like have a friend open their door and be shocked and greeted with a nutcracker like that. And then we go onto the kitchen stuff. If you have one of those special coffee machines that you can buy with block bucks, there is actually a peppermint mocha in here and it looks so cute. As you can see, it has a little candy cane inside it, and a lot of people don't actually know that you can do it. So if you have block bucks, get one of those coffee machines and you can make your own peppermint mocha like that. I almost just slammed the door in my face, but that's all right. And then of course, we go into the kitchen. Very important stuff to keep in mind here as well. There is some Christmas items that you can cook that will disappear, like the holiday cookies, gingerbread house, but you cannot eat that. I don't know what will happen with the cheesecake and like the velvet cupcakes and stuff like that, because they're not really Christmassy. So I hope that they will stay, but I would make sure to cook some of those just in case they disappear, because I don't know whether they will stay or not. I think the cheesecake is gonna stay because that's just a general thing, but I am not sure actually. Definitely want some of these cakes here. So yeah, I'm gonna be cooking a little bit and just storing some of them. Gingerbread cookies want a lot of them as well. And do you also have that where you stock up a lot of stuff that you actually never use, but you just stock it up just in case, but then you never actually place it? That's me. But oh well. Now anyways, I'm going to leave it at this. I think I went over the most important things to stock up for Christmas. The hanging lights and stuff like that, don't worry about them too much. Just don't use custom placement on them if you want to stock some of the Christmas ones up. Keep in mind to check whether it says will be deleted after Christmas or not, because if it says so, then it will be. I still need to remove my Halloween stuff from this house, but ugh, been a bit lazy with Halloween stuff removal lately, if that makes sense. I did freeze over my lake because I couldn't wait for Christmas, so I already have an ice skating lake at my house. But yeah, I'm working on a new one, might upload the video, well, or it is already uploaded by the time I upload this video. Now I'm gonna leave it at this. Thank you so much for watching. Hit that like button, and please subscribe.